Get ready to match the stars. Robert Q. Lewis. Brett Summers. Maury Amsterdam. Joyce Boulafont. Richard Dawson. And Ann Elder. As we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 73. And now here's the host of Match Game 73, Gene Rayburn.
It's Geraldine.
Hello there.
Hello there. Thank you.
Jennifer Dan.
Yes, sirree. Thank you very much. How's old Johnny Olson? Good. I thank you for the warmth of your reception. Thank you for joining us wherever you are. And nice to see all of you. Is everybody ready to have a go at it?
Yes.
Terrific.
What are you doing?
Look,
are you
like
playing with your cards?
Yesterday.
He's playing with my cards.
He's playing with your cards?
Look at what he does.
Oh, stop that.
Don't you recognize modern art when you see it?
All right. Let's say hello to our two players, shall we? Jerry Mayo and Ellen Hoey. Hello, players. If you were with us last time, you know that Ellen is the current champ. She's done very well here. She's up to $11,550. She's won three games, and she's being challenged by Jerry. We started this game last time out, finished round one, and had no score at all. We'll go to round two and see who scores right after we see about this. Okay, we're ready to have a go at it. Are you all ready?
Ready.
I'll push the button, reveal the questions for round two, and ask Jerry to make a selection.
I'll do it different this time. I'll go to A.
He wants A. Everybody will play.
Very wise thing to do.
Yes.
I hope. Count Dracula was so absent-minded, he left his blank on the subway.
Did you hear that, Jerry? Count Dracula was so absent-minded, he left his blank on the subway. You know about Count Dracula? Very good, Brett. First point.
Very good, Mar. You got it in there.
Ann is having a little trouble with this one. Sorry about that, Ann.
Come along.
I'm sorry. I'm doing the best I can.
All right. Now we're all ready. We'll call on Jerry for his response. Count Dracula was so absent-minded, he left his...
Cape
on the subway. They like that answer. Let's see if our celebrities like that answer. Cape is his. What is yours?
My answer is fangs.
Okay. Brett, what did you say?
What is Jerry so depressed about? I've never seen a man smile as much as he does. I said cape, darling.
Good girl. I get more. All right. Maury, what about fangs? Fangs. He's got fangs on his head. You have a cape or fangs?
Well, he was singing fangs for the memory, but he left his cape.
I matched the girls.
Okay, so you're up to two now, Jerry. Let's see.
He did happen to leave his fangs on the subway.
His fangs?
Unfortunately, in the neck of the conductor.
What do you say?
I say that Count Dracula was very old. He left his false teeth.
Aha! Just for that, they will bite you in the neck.
Oh, I hope so.
Okay, so that was two. Two for you, Jerry. And let's see how Ellen does with hers. Now, Ellen, you must score twice to stay in the game and to achieve a tie. Three, however, will win the game for you. This is it. Sweet Leilani hired a gardener to blank her grass skirt. All right. Sweet Leilani hired a gardener to blank her grass skirt.
You're right, Gene. It is better if you don't think.
Okay. All right. Everybody ready over there? Let's see what Ellen has to say. Sweet Leilani hired a gardener to blank her grass skirt.
Water?
To water her grass skirt? Well, you know, you water grass. You don't like that, do you? You don't think it's going to win. All right. Two to tie, three to win. Robert Q., what do you say?
Usually she asked him to rotate her crops, but...
Oh, my Lord!
Actually, in this case, her grass skirt needed mowing.
Mowing. To mow the grass skirt. Brett, what do you say?
Well, she wanted Christian Dior, but he died, so she got the gardener to trim it.
Trim the grass skirt. She says water the grass skirt.
I was going to say water, too, but I figured she could do that herself.
Oh. Okay.
I just said mow. That's my name anyway, Mo.
Oh, that's right, Maury. All right. What do you say, sweet lady? Here?
I think she wanted to go along with the fashions. It was too long, so he asked her to cut it.
To cut the grass skirt. You must match Richard and Anne to achieve a tie and stay in the game. What do you say?
I say, let's go to my place, have a drink.
Oh, no. I say, you hired the gardener to weed her
weed.
Grass.
Weed! So, Jerry is the winner. Congratulations. And come down, please. Yes. Right here, if you would, please. Happy about that? Good. Good. Now, Ellen, this is the end of the line for you, but it's been a pleasant trip for us to have you with us here, and I hope it's been pleasant for you. Has it been?
Yes, it has.
How much money are you walking out of here with?
$11,000.
$11,550. Congratulations, and thank you, Ellen Hoey. Goodbye. Yeah, Jerry's applauding louder than everybody. Are you happy? You're happy for her, right?
I'm happy for me, and I'm happy for her.
Okay. Well, Jerry, we're going to see how you're going to do with the super match here. You're going to have a go at $5,600, over $5,000, or 55, or whatever it is there, right after this message.
Hello.
Okay, here we are with Jerry Mayo, and we're going to have a go at the super match. You ready, Jerry?
I'm ready.
All right. We polled a recent studio audience. And we got their best response to this. Peg blank. Now, the answer they gave most often is worth $500 to you if you match it. The second most frequent response, $250. The third, $100. Three celebrities are allowed to help, one at a time, if you please.
Maury.
Maury, how do you handle this? Peg blank.
Peg leg.
Peg leg, you say. All right.
Anne.
Anne.
Pegboard.
Pegboard, she says. One more.
Richard.
How about Peg of my heart?
How about it?
A like great little dad, sir.
Yes. All right, so you got pegboard, peg leg, and peg of my heart. You may choose one of those as the answer, Jerry, or give us one of your own. What would you like to do?
Leg, the answer.
Peg leg. Okay. Yeah. Are you letting the audience influence you?
I don't know.
All right. Blank.
You're a blank?
Yeah. Fill me in.
All right. He's looking for the answer. Peg leg. Let's find out if it's up there at all. First, may we see the $100 response? Peg of my heart is there, the answer. Richard Dawson gave us that answer, peg of my heart. Still no peg leg. Here is the $250 response. Pegboard is up there. You're getting close, Jerry. Here is your third and last chance. Here is the $500 response. Pegboard!
Yeah. Got it!
There's the answer Maury gave you.
We're winning.
Okay. Now.
He's still trying to sell a car.
You've won the $500. You play for 10 times that amount, or $5,000. But to collect the money, you got to match one celebrity head-to-head. Has to be an exact match. Which one will it be?
Maury.
I'll stick with him.
Gonna stick with Maury. All right, Maury, sure. You get ready to write. Jerry, you face me, if you would, please.
I'll take 10% right now.
The $5,000 question. Blank drop. D-R-O-P. Blank drop. Or blank drop. We appreciate your enthusiasm, but you may be giving him a rotten answer. There's Maury is finished. Now, Jerry, how do you fill in this blank? Blank drop.
Lemon. Lemon.
Lemon drop.
Lemon.
No.
That's your answer, lemon drop.
Can I change it?
Can I give you three or four?
No, thanks, no. He's a hustler, isn't he? Okay, Maury, for $5,000, may we see your answer? His is lemon drop. See if it matches.
I don't think you've been looking at the same mystery show as I have. Money drop.
Money drop. All right.
So, Jerry, you've got $600 to your credit. You're still a champ. You're going to meet another player and play another game. Here comes Barbara Maybeno. Mayben. Hello, Barbara.
Hi.
You know Jerry, Barbara?
Yes, I sure do.
It's Barbara Maybeno, right?
Maybeno.
Maybeno. Oh.
Maybe
oh.
Yes, maybe no.
All right. Would you like to tell us a little more, Barbara?
Well, I'm an art student at Cal State Long Beach, and I'm majoring in interior design.
You're majoring in interior design?
Right, I want to be an interior designer.
Well, good luck to you in that venture.
Thank you.
Good luck to you here, too, Barbara.
Thank you.
Are you ready?
Right.
Here, I'll push a button. Bing, there it goes. Barbara, would you please make a selection?
I think I'll take B.
B is for Barbara. This is it, folks. Fatima said to her girlfriend, "Believe me, it's easy to get blank on a bed of nails." Fatima said that to her girlfriend.
There are several choices to that question.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Fatima said to her girlfriend, "Believe me, it's easy to get blank on a bed of nails." Think about it for a second, Barbara. All right, Richard, are you ready?
Yeah, I am. I've just felt it strong, and my sons are shrunk at home, and what comes after hello would be
all
thy
set,
name?
So we'll call on Barbara for her response. Fatima said to her girlfriend, "Believe me, it's easy to get blank on a bed of nails."
I'd have to say spiked.
Spiked? You said spiked.
She because said of the nails,
folks.
Dear.
It's a bed of nails, all right. Here we go. Spiked is her answer. Robert, what did you say?
Well, I've had the habit, so I said hooked.
Hooked on a bed of nails. All right. Brett, your
well,
answer?
Well, after being married to Jack Klugman for 17 and a half years, my dear, I've been scratched a lot on a bed of nails.
Really? All right. Maury, what do you say?
Stuck.
Okay. Joyce?
I kind of slept in the same bed.
Really?
Well, you're the...
You're supposed to be very happy.
Remember your image.
Go ahead, Richard.
Yeah, exactly the same. Pierced on a bed of nails.
Spiked and pierced is a match.
Well, I'll drink to that.
All right, Ann, what do you
say? Well, I took it very literally. I said it was easy to get nailed on a bed of nails.
That's a match. It's easy to get nailed on a bed of nails. Come to my dressing room later. We'll talk there. All right, Jerry, what do we got for you here?
A
is for again. Jerry. Everybody plays. Here's a little poem for you. Are you ready for a little poem?
Yeah.
I like poetry, actually.
Oh, me too.
Here
I got
it is.
A beauty. Fat and skinny went to bed. Fat rolled over. Skinny's dead. Spent 3 years with Burma Shave.
How am I going to top that? I'm going to try with this. Corsets are tight, moo-moos are loose. For Henry's last birthday, Jane gave him a blank.
Corsets are tight.
Moo-moos are loose.
Yeah.
For Henry's last birthday, Jane gave him a blank.
I just went off poetry.
Thank you. All right. We're waiting for Miss Shy over there. Now she's ready. And Jerry, how do you complete the poem? Corsets are tight, moo-moos are loose. For Henry's last birthday, Jane gave him a...
noose.
A noose. He says noose, Bob.
That's not good news. I know that couple. The way they celebrate their birthday, she gave him a goose.
A goose. Okay. Brett?
Jerry, that's one of the most terrible answers I've ever heard in my entire life. Noose.
Oh, noose. There's the man. Score is 2-1. Okay.
I guess the two of them mean she gave him a geese.
There's another... noose is the answer he's looking for. What have you got to offer,
well,
Joyce?
Well, the price of meat, she gave him a moose.
A moose. All right. Noose is Jerry's answer, Richard.
Can you be in the office at 9?
No noose is good noose.
Ties the score, Ann.
friend.
Well, I said I wanted to make this kind of ladylike, so I said a goose, and then I added gander after it.
A gander. Yes. Yes. That's very
don't
ladylike.
Bother,
I think so.
Don't bother,
I think
so. Dear.
Okay, so at the end of round one, it's 2-2. We'll see what happens in round two right after this message for you. Okay. We've finished round one. I'll push the button, reveal the questions for round two, and ask Barbara to make a selection.
I'll stick with B again.
B is what she wants. Last time out, Barbara, you matched two of our celebrities, Richard and Ann, so the two of you will not participate in this.
Very well.
Okay. The mad scientist tried to make his girlfriend completely disappear. I beg your pardon. Wait a minute. The mad scientist tried to make his girlfriend completely invisible, but he couldn't make her blank disappear. Aren't you glad you're not playing?
I wish I weren't.
The mad scientist tried to make his girlfriend completely invisible, but he couldn't make her blank disappear. Put something down on those cards, if you would please. Barbara, are you thinking about that?
Yeah, I'm thinking.
All right. Joyce is ready.
Lip.
Your lip, right. Speechless, are you? Okay, everybody's ready, so Barbara, we'll call for your response now. The mad scientist tried to make his girlfriend completely invisible, but he couldn't make her...
her rear end. It was so big.
I see. He couldn't make that disappear. Her derriere. All right, Bob Q, what do you say?
Her temper.
Her temper disappear. Okay, that is a good answer, isn't it?
I don't like it, no.
Yeah, no,
you know, I've been on the wagon for 2 days. I had a couple of really terrible hangovers, and I'm going back to drink as soon as this show is over. What did I say? Shiny teeth.
Her shiny teeth.
Now you understand why I'm
going back.
Yeah,
you better start drinking again, Brent. All right, Maury, what do you say?
Well, I'm trying to think of the last part of somebody that would disappear. Her nose.
Her nose!
She had a very big nose. She took a trip to Europe once, stuck her head out the porthole, and turned the boat around.
All right. Joyce, may we see your answer?
Well, I think he couldn't make her wig disappear.
Her wig disappeared.
Oh, that's a good one.
Okay, so you didn't score with that, and we'll go to Jerry this round. Jerry, the score at this moment is tied. One match for you will win the game. Here we go. John had Martha's tongue blanked. Last time out, you matched Richard.
I know the answer to that because Jack tried to do it to me.
You did not participate, neither does Richard. Everybody else does. John had Martha's tongue blanked. Maury is ready.
R-E-A-D-Y.
Oh, yes, ready.
Okay, everybody's ready. Jerry.
Yes.
John had Martha's tongue blanked.
I'm not ready. Now what do I do? No encore there. John had Martha's tongue...
blanked.
Capped. Tooth, tongue, huh?
Capped.
No, you can't talk with a cap on your tongue, you know.
I guess that's his answer, folks. You're stuck with it. There, here we go.
He's smiling.
I must have been a dentist.
What do you say, Robert?
Well, I wanted to have him put her back on the wagon and have it pickled, but I have cut out.
Cut out. Yes. Okay, we go over to Maury.
He didn't want to hear it, but he wanted to remember it, so he had it bronzed.
Bronzed. I guess he didn't have the same John and Martha in mind that you had in mind there. Joyce, what do you say?
I think any John wants Martha's tongue cut out.
Cut out. Okay. Ann Elder, what do you say?
And I said removed.
Removed.
Yes.
She said cap.
You're so late.
All right. So this game, folks, ends in a tie. And I'll tell you what happens when we have a tie. Shazam and wipe the board clean like that and push the button. And nothing happened. No, there it is. And we come to a tie thing here. Now, we got one question for each of you. And the one who's scored the most, well, I will be the winner. All right, Barbara, make a selection, if you would, please.
I might as well try B one more time.
B, she says, one more time. Everybody plays. Fay Wray said to King Kong. You're a nice guy, but you're too blank. All right, do it as quickly as we can. Let's see if we can resolve this tie. Quickly, Brett.
I'm in there.
Okay, everybody ready. So, Barbara, would you give us your response, please?
Could you repeat it, please? I didn't
hear. Faye Ray said to King Kong, you're a nice guy, but you're too...
Harry.
Harry. All right. She says, Harry, Bob, what do you say?
Harry.
Harry.
Got it, Harry.
Holy moly. Yeah, let's say one at a time. Brett said Harry, and he says...
She said Harry, and I say Harry. There are three Harrys.
Three Harrys there.
One George.
All right, what do you say, Joyce?
I think he was too tall.
Too tall. No match there, Richard?
One more Harry, and we've got the Rich Brothers. Harry.
All right, and...
And I said Harry.
Harry, another one. That's five for you. And you have to stand by because we've got a message for you, and this is it. Okay, sorry to delay the suspense here, Jerry, but you've got to come back next time to resolve this tie. Will you do that?
I will do it.
Okay, see you next time. See all of you next time. See you on the new Perry Mason. Hear you on KFI. And we look forward to seeing all of your beautiful faces and bodies here. Gene Rayburn from Match Game 73. Join us whenever.
Today's consolation prizes are a Texas Instruments calculator. Adds, subtracts, multiplies, divides in the palm of your hand. Advanced electronic technology at your fingertips from Texas Instruments. And from the Chapstick people, Chap-Hands Cream, specially formulated for problem hands. An effective cream you can use to soothe and soften rough, dry hands. And Rice-A-Roni, the big flavor side dishes, so quick, so easy. Sauté and simmer to flavor perfection. Rice-A-Roni, the San Francisco treat. This is Johnny Olson speaking for Match Game 73, a Mark Goodson, Bill Totman production.